sa motor. Uyan na sa dagat.
Super Typhoon Pepito has wreaked havoc across the Philippines, with wind speeds reaching 200 kilometers per hour and gusts of up to 240 kilometers per hour. The powerful storm has caused widespread destruction, becoming one of the strongest to hit this year. As the sixth typhoon to strike the Philippines in just 1 month, Pepito highlights an alarming rise in intense weather events linked to climate change. On November 17th, it battered Aurora and northern Quezon, uprooting trees, severing power lines, and tearing roofs from homes. Aurora's communities, familiar with typhoons, were not prepared for the devastation caused by Pepito's unprecedented strength. Streets are covered in debris, power lines are downed, and families are scrambling to salvage whatever they can. Aurora's thriving tourism has come to a halt. Popular tourist destinations are closed indefinitely, while authorities patrol the coastline for safety. In Albay, powerful storm surges submerged coastal barangays, displacing residents and causing further damage. Despite widespread flooding, some regions maintained electricity and mobile signals, allowing emergency services to coordinate rescue operations. Authorities issued evacuation orders as storm surges reached up to 3 meters along the coast.
Ingat-ingat tayo mga lord.
Rescue teams swiftly evacuated vulnerable communities, especially those at risk of landslides and flooding. Evacuation centers have become shelters, stocked with essential relief supplies for displaced families. Road closures from fallen trees and debris have delayed rescue efforts. Emergency crews are working around the clock to clear vital routes and continue their life-saving missions despite the storm's relentless winds and rains. The frequency and severity of typhoons in 2024 have raised concerns among climate scientists. While the Philippines typically experiences 20 typhoons annually, the rapid succession of severe storms this year is unprecedented, with climate change being a significant factor. rising ocean temperatures are intensifying storms like Pepito, making them more destructive and harder to predict. In addition to the immediate devastation, communities face long-term challenges, including displacement and economic losses. Super Typhoon Pepito is expected to move past Manila and into the South China Sea by Monday, but the damage has already been done. Coastal areas remain on high alert for further flooding, and urban centers brace for potential power outages and infrastructural damage.
Tunog ka.